first championship of the year for us. SEC Western Division champions, 21 wins in conference, something I'm very, very proud of, quite frankly. If you think back to the preseason, were there four or five teams in the top 10 or 12 in the country from the SEC West? So to win the SEC West third division, I think, is a great accomplishment for our team. Every year you go into it thinking, if you can win 20 ball games, you got a shot at the SEC title. Well, we're at 21, and we're going to need some help to be able to do that. But I would hope that winning the SEC West with the job we've done in our non-conference games would give us a really good shot at being a national seed. And I'm just really proud of the guys. You know, we won all five of our series on the road this year, and most of them in very tough environments to win. Mississippi State, Arkansas, this place, are you kidding me? I'm just, words can't even express how proud I am of our guys. You know, sometimes we're our own worst enemy. You know, we do some things that, you know, make me scratch my head, you know, getting picked off at the bases loaded, nobody out, you know, or a few other little things, but you can't ever argue about the grit and determination of our team. People like Cotton, and, you know, realize this was like deja vu all over again, you know, as Yogi Berra would say. The Arkansas game, Ross led off with a double. We used Foster to pinch run for him, bunted him over the third base, and then McMullen hit a sacrifice fly to drive him home, and Cotton closed it out. So we'll take those kind of victories every time.
It's also like South Carolina last year. You had weather issues to deal with.
Yeah.
And you had to go extra innings in the final game.
That's right. You know, those things don't just happen, us winning games like that in places like this. You know, it takes a lot of kids with a lot of courage, a lot of composure, a lot of poise, a lot of talent, a lot of confidence, a lot of belief in each other. You know, after a while you start thinking it's not a coincidence when you win these kind of games, especially on the road. So, hey, it's going to be nice to go home. I hope the only times we'll be on the road the rest of the year now will be in Hoover and Omaha. We get to be home for New Orleans game Tuesday, and next weekend with Ole Miss, we'll go away to Hoover, and then hopefully we'll host the regional and the super regional, and we'll let these wonderful fans follow us to Omaha someday. That'd be awesome.
Everything y'all had to deal with, wasn't it kind of like an SEC tournament or a regional?
Sure felt like it. You know, I mean, when we got rained out last night, the game got suspended. I told our players that if we get the job done in the last three innings, we're going to play for a championship. This is our first chance of playing for a championship, and it's an awesome feeling to go to bed at night knowing that the next day you're going to wake up and play for a championship. And I told the guys that, and they came out and responded. You know, for a while there, it was tough. You know, it was hard to get runs there. The wind's falling in, and their pitcher did a nice job of mixing his pitches, and then because it was a seven-inning game, they were able to bring their closer in so early. Well, I guess we were able to also, but it, you know, made it tough to string a lot of hits together. So, hey, we did what we could, what we needed to. We got the win, and we're just really proud.
So all the things you like about McMullen, the fact that he strikes out twice, or gets down 0-2, and still finds a way to fight through, is that kind of typified?
He's a tough kid, Randy. Sean McMullen is a tough, tough kid, and I see his confidence growing every day. He's not in awe of anything anymore. He feels he belongs. He doesn't belong. And, you know, to stand up there in this environment with two strikes on you after striking out your two previous at-bats, I was just hoping he wouldn't take a close one and leave it up to the umpire because he struck out those two times on called strikes and didn't quite agree with the call. But fortunately, he put the bat on the ball, and if it wasn't for the wind, it might have been gone. But, you know, fortunately, we got to run across and were able to hold on. Typical Ryan, you know, just typical Ryan. Every inning, you know, we got people on base, got guys in scoring position, and then he just raises his game and makes some big pitches. We had some big double plays, or, you know, at least one big double play to get us out of an inning. But, you know, I've just come to accept that that's the way it's going to be with Ryan. You know, you're just not going to have one, two, three innings very often. But thank goodness the kid has some conniption about him. That's such a word. Yeah. He's got something about him that he can raise his game to another level. I'd much rather have a kid like that than somebody just dominates sometimes, and then when things start going bad, he falls apart. So that's who Ryan Needs is, and I'm glad he's on our team.
It's convention and Jeremy.